This is a 2016 Ford F-650. Sorry, excuse me for a second. This is a 2016 Ford F-650, and it is the ultimate pickup truck. You've heard of supercars, of course. Well, this is a super truck, one of the largest pickup trucks on the planet. And today, I'm going to review it. I've borrowed this F-650 from CNC Motors, which is an exotic car dealership here in Southern California that has an amazing inventory of amazing cars, everything from million-dollar exotics to old cars to, well, weird stuff like this. They have one of the most incredible showrooms of any car dealership on the planet, and you can check them out by clicking the link in the description below. Now, you surely know the Ford F-Series, which is the best-selling vehicle in America. Most people buy the Ford F-150, which is plenty capable for almost all needs. If you need to tow or haul something specific, maybe you upgrade to the F-250. And if you really want to pull something huge, then you get an F-350. And the vast majority of consumers think that that's where the Ford F-Series lineup ends. But it doesn't, because this is an F-650. In fact, the Ford F-Series lineup goes all the way up to the F-750, but most of these higher numbered trucks are typically commercial vehicles like tow trucks or ambulances or dump trucks. But not this one. This is just a regular old pickup truck, except massive. Now, Ford doesn't sell it this way. They sell the F-650 with a cab and then just a basic bare stripped chassis, they call it. And then this company called Super Trucks converts it into a pickup with luxury features and a pickup truck bed. Now, the F-650 weighs 10,000 pounds before that conversion. So this thing really is huge. Fortunately, it has a good engine to handle all that power. It's got a 6.7 liter Power Stroke V8 that makes about 330 horsepower and about 750 pound-feet of torque. So anyway, today I'm going to review the F-650. First, I'm going to take you on a tour of it and show you all the interesting quirks and features of the ultimate pickup truck. Then I'm going to get it out on the road and drive it, and then I'm going to give it a Doug score. And for more of my thoughts on the F-650, click the link below to visit autotrader.com/oversteer. All right, I'm gonna start the quirks and features of the F-650 with simply getting inside. And as you can see, this is a truck with a staircase. Because it is massive. But there is a problem with the staircase. The lowest stair is still really high up. You can see I have to lift my leg really far, and if you're like old or small, you might not be able to do this. So even with the staircase, it's hard to get in. Fortunately, they've thought of that. You open the door and another stair deploys. So now you have an even larger staircase. But this is more than enough to be able to climb step one, step two, step three into the F-650, and then you're finally in. Same deal when you get out. You start here at the top, step one, step two, step three. You're out, you shut the door, and then the additional stair retracts back into the vehicle. And it's worth noting that that folding stair isn't unique just to the driver's side of this truck. They have the same thing on the passenger side and in the back. You open the rear door and once again, the stair automatically extends out and then you climb on in to get into the F-650 and then you're in. And again, same deal to get out. Step one, step two, step three. And only then are you comfortably out of the F-650. And next up, I'm not quite done with this staircase to get into the F-650, because this isn't just a staircase, it's also a fuel tank. If you look down at the back end, you will see a big cap on top of it, and that's where you stick diesel fuel in this thing. And there are two of these. There's one giant fuel tank on the driver's side that includes these steps, and then there's one giant fuel tank on the passenger side that includes these steps. So this truck has two fuel tanks. for a total of 115 gallons of fuel. At the current price of diesel, filling up this truck is something like $400 or $500, but such is the price you pay to drive the ultimate pickup truck. But down the side of this truck, it isn't all fuel tanks. In fact, this is a cargo compartment. You open it up, turn this little latch, and then you can see you can stick in some cargo in here. And in fact, same thing on the other side, over on the passenger side of the truck, in the same spot, there is another cargo compartment, just like this one, that you could open up and put stuff in, which I think is actually a pretty good idea, because otherwise this would just be wasted space. And one of the big problems with pickup trucks is there's no trunk, you can't lock anything. But with this, you can. You'll notice there is a separate key lock. You can stick your stuff in here and no one will get to it. And next we move on to the bed, which is rather ridiculous. Now, I say that because, like I mentioned before, Ford sells the F650 as a stripped chassis, which means it has a cab and then back here just chassis rails, and you can add whatever you want in the back. Now, most companies add like a tow truck or a dump truck or an ambulance box, but in order to make this into the ultimate pickup, Super Trucks just adds the regular bed from the Ford F-350 dually. It matches, and pretty much that's all they have available to them. But this creates some problems. I will start with the fuel door. Now, I showed you earlier how you add fuel to the giant fuel tanks in here, but the F-350 bed comes with a fuel door when you buy it. So you open up this fuel door and there's just holes there. It looks absolutely ridiculous, stupid, unfinished, but that's just the reality when you stick on a bed from a different vehicle. And next up, we move on to the next problem created by the bed, and that would be the problem with the tire. Now, the regular F-350 uses normal streetcar tires, obviously huge ones, but they work for normal road-going vehicles. But the F-650 uses these massive commercial-grade tires you'd see on like a crane or a dump truck. And so, these tires don't fit under this wheel well because they were never designed to go here. So if you actually look at the wheel well, you'll see the top of the tire fits into the bottom of the wheel well, but if it went any higher, it would cut off the tire and it wouldn't actually be able to turn. And so, for the first time in the entire history of one of my reviews, I can confidently say that this wheel well is purely here for decoration, since it doesn't really have any function, since it can't actually contain the tire. And then we move on to the most serious problem with the bed, and that would be its usefulness. What do you need a pickup truck bed for? To put stuff in. Well, you can do that in this truck, but the problem is, when you drop the bed, it comes up to my stomach, or even a little bit higher. There's no way you could ever get something into this bed, especially anything heavy, if you wanted to carry it around. So you have this massive truck with this incredibly capable chassis, and you can't even put anything back here in order to drive it anywhere, because nobody can get into this bed. That is probably the biggest bed-related flaw. It's almost like the entire bed is there just for aesthetic style reasons. But anyway, speaking of the bed, if you were to actually be able to get something in here, you would find that it's just a pretty standard Ford F-350 Super Duty bed. Nothing unusual, nothing particularly special in the bed of the 650. But while the inside of the bed may not be particularly interesting, there are quite a few other interesting quirks and features on the outside of the F-650. I'm gonna start with the mud flaps. This thing has such massively huge tires that it has to have massively huge mud flaps. These look like they've come right off a semi-truck. They are really intense. In fact, the mud flaps are so huge, they have their own turn signals. You put on the turn signal and one specifically lights up on the top of the mud flaps. And speaking of excessive lighting, that's a bit of a theme on this particular F-650. When you put on the turn signals, four separate signal lights light up in the back of this truck on either side. You have the one in the mud flaps, then there's one right below the bed, you have one in the normal taillight brake light housing, and then you have one at the top of the cab in the back. So there are many different ways this truck lets you know that it's changing lanes or turning from the back. And the theme of this truck being a little over-eager to let you know that it's changing lanes continues down the side, where you also have an enormous number of turn signals. You have one on the front fender, you have one in the side mirror, and then you have four separate LED turn signals on each side under the doors, letting other drivers know that you're changing lanes. This is not due to any regulation. It's clear to me that this truck was just owned by like an LED lighting enthusiast who wanted a lot of different lights whenever anything happened. But probably the most insane exterior feature of this truck is the front end design. You look at this front end and it's clear that this is Ford's giant commercial vehicles. This doesn't look anything like a regular pickup. And I guess that's why people buy it. Their neighbor just got an F-350, they wanna show them up, so they get this. And no one will ever confuse this for any regular pickup truck when you see the front end of this thing. It is just ridiculously huge. Especially huge and massive in this truck is this giant front bumper, which sticks out like a foot and a half beyond the front of the trunk. It's chrome on the front, this matte black on the top, and I can completely sit on it, which isn't something I can do in most of the cars I review. I'm not sitting on a lot of Pagani Huayra bumpers, but you can do it in this thing because it's just so tough and massive and insane. It's worth noting this bumper will also push anything out of the way. And since we're up front, we might as well talk engine. Like I mentioned, this is Ford's 6.7 liter power stroke turbo diesel V8, 330 horsepower, about 750 pound-feet of torque, pretty healthy numbers. But my favorite thing is how you access the engine. There is no little latch you pull in the driver footwell. Instead, you walk over to the passenger side and undo this little strap. Then you come over to the driver's side, you undo the same strap, and then it's all about brute strength and force in order to get this absolutely massive hood up. But once you do, you can see the engine, although it's still about 6.5 feet on the ground, so it's not like you're gonna have all that much access to it. And by the way, since I'm up front, it's worth noting that the massive LED lighting theme of this truck continues up front. You can see there are four separate LEDs in this giant front bumper. Now, you turn these on with the four auxiliary switches in the cabin. If you press them all to turn them all on, you will turn on the lights in front, all four of them, the two circles and the two in the middle, and you will also turn on all the lights in the back. There is a giant LED above the bed that goes on, and then there are two more LEDs in the rear bumper. Again, I'm not sure what the obsession was with LEDs, but when they're all on, this truck is very unmistakable. And next, we move on to the inside of the F-650. And by the way, my camera and tripod is as high as it possibly goes right now. This setup has worked for every other car I've ever reviewed, but it is not tall enough for the F-650. And it looks like you're like a little puppy looking into a car. Come play with me. But anyway, moving on to the interior. Now, the interior here is not as interesting as the exterior, mostly because this is effectively just a regular F-Series Super Duty truck cab put on this ridiculous body. So there's nothing particularly interesting or weird, but there are some quirks and features worth noting, the biggest of which is the transmission situation. This truck has an automatic like you'd expect, but it doesn't have park. Take a look in the gauge cluster. You can see all the other gears are there, but there's no P. Instead, in order to park this truck, you put it in neutral, and then there's this giant floor-mounted parking brake. You pull that, and then the truck is parked, like a manual transmission car or an exotic car with like a dual clutch or an F1 Ferrari transmission. I have never seen this in any other vehicle, but it's in this one. And next up, there are some other interesting quirks and features in here worth noting. For example, in the center control stack, there's a little fuel icon, and you can see there's a switch marked L and R. This is to switch between left and right fuel tanks. So if you run out of fuel in your 60-gallon tank on one side, just switch over to the 50-gallon tank on the other, and just keep on going. And next up, another interesting item in that center control stack, there's a button that's marked hold 2 sec with like arrows next to a truck bed. If you press that button, it will actually lower the truck to make it a little bit easier to get stuff into the bed. Unfortunately, it's not easy enough. The bed is still really, really high up, and there's not really all that much you can do to change it because there's so much hardware underneath. But that does make it just a little easier. Now, when you want to raise the bed back up again, just press the button again for 2 seconds, and the truck will come right back up. and then you can drive along like normal. And next up, another interesting button in the center control stack. To the right of the steering wheel, there is a button with what looks like a little cloud on it. You press that and it will restrict the exhaust gases for the engine. The theory here is you use that button when you're going downhill. You press it and then it will restrict the exhaust flow from the engine, and that will make the engine a little bit harder to turn, and that will slow down the engine and thus the truck. And that way, when you're going downhill, you don't have to ride your brakes, which is especially a big problem if you're towing a trailer. It's very heavy, it will burn out your brakes quickly, but you press that and it will slow you down a little bit more than usual. And next up, to the left of the steering wheel, you have a little black button. That one wasn't put there by Ford. You know that because it's unlabeled. And what that does is it turns on the train horn. Of course, the kind of person who would want a truck like this would want a train horn. So let's listen to it very briefly. And finally, moving on to the last interesting button in this interior, this one over on the driver's door panel, there's a little button there with a mirror on it. You press that and it moves the mirrors in or out, which is really incredible because if you're towing a trailer, a lot of times you have to stick on like an extended mirror to see behind the trailer. Well, in this thing, you just push the button and the mirrors you already have just slide out a little further. When you take the trailer off, press the button again and the mirror comes right back to normal. It really makes towing life a lot easier. But other than those interesting buttons and the weird park neutral thing, this truck has a pretty basic interior, and you can tell that it was originally intended to be a fairly basic commercial vehicle. For one thing, you have three across seating up front, no luxury fancy center console in here. You also have a plastic dashboard, plastic glove box, plastic steering wheel. Nothing here looks particularly nice. Again, this was intended to be a basic work truck until it got converted, and the company that converted it put in these nice heated leather seats, but at its core, it's still a pretty basic vehicle. And finally, we move on to the back seat of the F650, and as you can probably tell, again, this was not intended to be a cool or interesting thing, just a back seat to go in a work truck to a job site, nothing particularly special. But the company that turned this into a super truck did add a couple of interesting quirks and features. One is the fact that this back seat folds down into a bed. You press this little button on the side and it will fold all the way flat, so you can sleep in the back of your F650 if you have to, and if you're kind of small because it's not a very big bed. And the other interesting quirk worth noting back here is that on the backs of the front seats, you have not just one storage pocket for documents, but two, which is twice what you get in a normal vehicle, proving again that this is the ultimate pickup truck. And so those are the quirks and features of the Ford F650. Now it's time to get this thing out on the road and see how it drives. All right, driving the F650, and I gotta say, I believe this is the highest, largest, most ridiculous thing that I have ever in my life driven. It is huge. I've driven Sprinter vans, I've driven big cargo vans, every type of full-size 2500 pickup, G-Wagon 6x6. This thing takes the cake. You are sitting so high, I now feel how semi-drivers must feel driving along. It is absolutely insane massive. I actually think of all the insanity I talked about earlier, I actually think in the first minute I can already tell driving it is actually the most insane part. This is just absolutely, I mean, I feel like I'm 25 feet up. I also can't imagine why anybody would want one of these things in most circumstances. I mean, it's so absurd and so ridiculous. Can't fit in any residential garage, can't fit in any parking garage. You gotta have a hanger for this or just leave it outside. Yeah, I mean, I'm even with, like, I'm next to a semi-truck, I'm even with the dude's cab. Like, there's no, basically you're driving around in a semi-truck except it's for personal use. Like, yeah, I got a semi-truck, no problem. There's not much more that's especially interesting or exciting about the driving experience. It drives like a huge truck, but probably even a little bit worse. The steering is really, really vague. There's really not all that much acceleration power. You don't really expect it. I mean, obviously, even though this thing is like the ultimate pickup craziness, it's still kind of designed for pulling and that sort of thing, and not for any sort of fun or exciting. I think the real fun you get is knowing you have this ridiculous, insane thing. I do have to admit, if you really want to be the king of the road, you know, in today's world, everybody said they wanted an SUV so they could sit up high, and now everybody's got an SUV so you can't sit up high and see over anything. But if you want to be the king of the road, forget the 6x6, you want one of these things. You want this or an International CXT or MXT, whatever, or Chevy Kodiak. You want, I mean, this is the absolute king. It's just, I can't imagine any actual rational, practical purpose for it, except to be the king of the road. Like, yeah, mine's bigger. It doesn't really matter what someone else has. Mine's bigger. I gotta be honest, as big as this thing looks from the outside, it feels even bigger on the inside. It is incredible to me how small regular cars feel when I'm driving in this thing. The acceleration is pretty labored. Ride quality is not the best. I mean, it's ultimately a Ford pickup. And it's a commercial chassis. It wasn't designed for like luxurious ride. It's just that, just like with the Hummer or whatever, there are some people who, they wanted one as a personal vehicle. This is just so egregiously high up. I just feel so superior to everyone else. And you also feel that you can run into stuff. I mean, I feel, especially that giant bumper on the front, I feel like it would be nothing if I started running down other vehicles, but also maybe even trees. And so that's the Ford F 650. You know, the Ford F-150 is pretty big. The F-250 and F-350 are huge. This thing is on another level. It is gargantuan, colossal, massive, whatever you want to call it. It is undoubtedly the ultimate pickup truck, whether or not that's a good thing. Anyway, now it's time for me to give the F-650 a Doug score.
Starting with the weekend categories and styling, the F-650 is a bit of an acquired taste. I wouldn't call it ugly, but it's certainly not beautiful, and it gets a 5 out of 10. Acceleration is very slow, and it gets a 1 out of 10. Handling is really bad, incredibly floaty and soft, not dangerous, but getting there, and it gets a 2 out of 10. Fun factor is okay, it's not that fun to drive, but I admit it is kind of fun to flex this thing, like the massive truck that it is, and it gets a 4 out of 10. Cool factor is reasonably high, non-truck people hate these, but truck people think it's awesome, and it gets a 6 out of 10 for a total weekend score of 18 out of 50. Next up are the daily categories and features. It's not very well equipped unless you count LED lights as features, and it gets a 3 out of 10. Comfort is surprisingly not that great, and it gets a 4 out of 10. Quality is fine, the interior isn't very nice, but these are reliable and durable, and it gets a 7 out of 10. Practicality is low, these are very capable, but also huge and impossible to take or park anywhere, and it gets a 3 out of 10. Finally, value, and these are huge money for what they are. Their appeal is incredibly narrow, and it gets a 4 out of 10 for a total daily score of 21 out of 50. Add it up and the Doug score is 39 out of 50. And here's the F-650 next to a bunch of other big and ridiculous trucks and SUVs I've reviewed. It loses badly. The F-650 is an absurd vehicle, and I highly do not recommend it unless you absolutely gotta have it. And if you're that type of person, well, then you don't care about its Doug score. You're too busy laughing at the peasants you run over as you drive around in your F-650.